नमस्ते, खुश रहो बिटिया। माई नेम इज़ जेवियन सचिन प्रताप सिंह, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मैथोडोलॉजी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जर्नलिज्म, प्रोग्राम बैचलर ऑफ जर्नलिज्म, कोर्स मीडिया लॉ एंड एथिक्स, सेशन डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल। द डायरेक्ट प्रिंसिपल ऑफ स्टेट पॉलिसी ऑफ इंडिया आर द गाइडलाइंस of 15 principle given to the Federal Institute governing the state of India to be kept in situ. Well, the framing law and policies, their provisions contained in part 4th article 36 to 51 of the Constitution of India are not enforceable by any court, but the principle laid down there in are considered in the governance of the country, making in the duty of the state apply these principle is making laws of stable establish a just society in the country. The principle have been inspired by the direct principle given in the Constitution of Ireland, which are related to social justice, economic welfare, foreign policy, and legal and administration matters. Direct principles are classified under the following categories: economics and socialized, political and administrative, justice and legal, environmental, protection of monuments, peace and security. Directive principle of state policy aim to create social and economic condition under which the citizen can lead a good life. They also aim to establish social and economic democracy through a welfare state. Through the directive principle are not justifiable rights of the people, but fundamental in the governance of the country. It shall be the duty of the state to apply these principle in making laws per Article 37. Besides, all executive agencies of union and state should also be guided by these principles. Even the judiciary has to keep them in mind in deciding cases. The directive principle ensure that the state shall strive to promote the welfare of the people by securing a social order in which social, economics, and political justice is animated, informed in all institution of life per Article 38(1). Also, the state shall strive to minimize the inequalities in income and endeavor to eliminate economics inequality as well as inequalities in states and opportunities, not only among individual but also among group of people in different areas or engaged in different vocation per Article 38(2). The state shall aim for securing right to an means of livelihood for all citizens, men and women, as well as equal pay for equal work for both men and women. The state should work to prevent concentration of wealth and means of production in a few hands and try to ensure that ownership and control of the material resources is distributed to best serve the common good. child abuse and exclusion of workers should has prevent children should be allowed to develop in a health manner and should be protect against exclusion and against moral and material per article 39 the state shall provide free legal aid to ensure that equal opportunities for securing justice is ensured to all and is not denied by reason of economics or other disabilities per article 20 39a the state shall provide free legal aid to ensure the that equal opportunities for securing justice is ensured to all and is not denied by reason of economic or other disabilities per article 39a the state shall also work for organization of village panchayats and help enable them to function as unit of self government per article 40 the state shall also work for organization of village panchayat the state shall endeavor to provide the right to work to education and to public assistance in cases of unemployment old age sickness and disablement within the limits of economics capacity per article 41 as well as provide for just and human condition of work relief per article 42 the state should also ensure living wage the state shall secure uniform civil code for all citizen per article 44 and provide earlier childhood care and education for all student for all children until they complete the age of 6 year per article 45 this directive regarding education of children was updated by the 86th amendment act 2002 it should work for the economics and educational for caste sc caste scheduled tribes and other weaker section of the society per article 46 थैंक यू बच्चों आपको ये सेशन समझ में आया होगा ठीक है अगर आपको ये इस सेशन में कोई भी प्रॉब्लम है बच्चों तो हम जो हमारी ऑनलाइन क्लासेस होगी जो गूगल मीट की क्लास होगी उस पर हम इस चैप्टर को दोबारा से क्लियर कर लेंगे अगर आपको कोई प्रॉब्लम है इस चैप्टर में इस सेशन में तो हम दोबारा से इस पर बात कर सकते हैं धन्यवाद बच्चों